Hey there and welcome. My name is Mr. Barry. In this whole video, we're going to be covering lesson number 16 of the computer literacy course. So let's give it a go, you and I. Come on. Lesson 16 is the last lesson of this course, so it's basically a review of every chapter that we've covered throughout the entire curriculum. We're going to be starting with that chapter, being the very first chapter of the book. Hey, here I am in my lesson number one. Now, lesson number one was very much the basics, getting into your Chromebook or getting into your Windows computer. The differences between a Chromebook and a Windows computer is gone over pretty quickly. So let's say that you're not sure. Do I have a Chromebook or do I have a Windows computer? Well, it's easy to find out. All you have to do is look down at the lower left-hand corner of your screen when you're doing your work, and if you see a circle down there, you're in a Chromebook. And instead, if you see a flag key over there, then guess what? You're in your Windows computer. Next, I talk about using the mouse and the differences between a left and a right click. Now, whenever you want to do a right click, let's say you're looking at the touchpad, you want to use two fingers there in a peace symbol and press at the same time with the two fingers, and then you should expect a little menu, and we call that a context menu, to appear out of the icon or the object that you're right clicking on. And a left click is done with just a single finger. Then I go over the differences between the Windows and the Chromebook's keyboards. If you look at those, you'll notice right away that there are different keys there and they're a little bit different spots. Now, you'll notice that, hey, where's my caps lock key and where's my delete key? Where's my other keys on my Chromebook? Well, it is easy to find them to use shortcuts. And here's a shortcut that I actually give you. It's Control Alt and then slash. And whenever you press that within a Chromebook, then you get a new window that pops up and has all the shortcuts that you can search through and find the one that you need. And after using the Chromebook for a few days, those new shortcuts should be right there and you won't have to be using the shortcut anymore to find that shortcut list. Then I go over using the internet and I introduce the URL address box up there and we go online and we actually go to different locations and we go in and we act like we're buying books and other things. And I warn the students, I say, now you have to watch where you're going on the URL address box. There should always be a padlock in the front of the address showing you that you're going to a secure location or a secured site, and that's really important before you enter in any type of information such as a credential information, password information, like that type of stuff, and that will help you know that you're in a secured site or not. Hey, and here's something else I thought I'd add. The other day someone asked me how to remove those URL suggestions that appear below the URL box as you're typing in a new address. Well, it's really easy. All you gotta do is take your mouse and when you see the suggestions, as you see I'm typing up here, go ahead and just take your mouse and click on the little X next to the suggestion and that suggestion is gone and you won't see it any longer. So it's really easy to remove those URL suggestions by clicking on the X. So there are other skills that we covered there in lesson number one, but you can always go back to lesson number one and actually see the full video if you need to. Let's jump into lesson number two. Hey, here we are in lesson number two. Now lesson number two goes beyond the basics so that the stuff that was given in number one was the very basics. You might consider that as the foundation. And lesson number two is beyond the foundation, maybe the walls of the house or something like that. And that's the way I build my lessons. Each lesson is built off of prior lesson given off from the previous lesson. So number one is the very basics. Number two is going beyond the basics. And here we have terminology. So we start with hardware terminology. As you see there, monitor, CPU. CPU standing for central processing unit. Then I go over the case, the box, the tower, the keyboard and mouse. And then we get into storage, and I talk about what storage means and basically what data means and saving all of your information there. Then we go over what's called cloud storage, and cloud storage is real important because now it's a way for us to save our information in basically a virtual vault that's up in the internet, and only you can get into it because only you have the username and password to unlock that vault and get into your data. And this is nice too if you're using a computer and that computer breaks. Well, what you can do is you can just buy a new computer and then log into your account, such as your Google account or your Microsoft account, and then go into your Google Drive, and there's all of your data. So in this lesson, we're really going to be going in and talking about your Google account, your Gmail, your Google Drive, and how to use those apps. And next we have software terms. Now, the first software term that we have there is OS, or operating system. And the operating system is the software that dictates the behavior of the device. So if you have a smartphone, maybe you have Android operating system that runs the device. If you have a desktop computer, maybe you have Windows 10 or Macintosh operating system. If you have a Chromebook, then you're running Chrome OS. So the software term that we have there, number one, is operating system. And like I said, that's very important. Another term there is we have screen resolution. So we go over many different terms, and I'm not going to cover all of them, but we do cover many different terms. Then we get into setting up your Google account. Now, if you already have a Google account, you don't have to do that. But many people coming into the class for the first time, they don't have a Google account. So we make sure that they create one and that they have one made just for them with a very long and complicated password that has letters, both upper and lowercase, numbers, as well as symbols. And then I give them a little trick there in class of how to memorize very long passwords very easily. And then after creating their account, basically I show them how to actually get in and then be able to use the different apps, such as the YouTube, Google Drive, the Gmail, Google Photos, and the other Google apps that are now given to them. And one of the big things that we cover in lesson number two is Gmail. We go over the interface, we show you how to use it. And as you can see here in this interface, you have Gmail at the very top there. And then below that, you have your inbox. Now your inbox is divided into three main areas: your primary, social, and then your promotions. So your primary, that would be holding all of your email that you receive from private parties. Your middle one there is social media. And so if you get email from or messages from social media, boom, it appears there. And your last box is promotion. That's as if a store sends you an email, it appears there in promotions. Now, the compose button there is meant so that you can compose a new email. So you'd click it, and then this would open up another box for you in front of your work. You would key in the email address, type in your message, click on the blue button that says send, and boom, you're sending off your email. So it's really easy to create email. As far as checking your email, all you have to do is just click on the subject line of any email, and then you'd click on the little arrow that would be over on the right hand side. There's a kind of like a little arrow there. You click that, that's called the reply arrow. And you click that, and then you open up at the bottom where you can then key in a message as a reply, and then click on the blue button to send it. We then go over the Google Drive. We talk about the elements of the Google Drive and its interface and how to use it, and as well as all of its settings. Even show you how to use it offline by going into the settings and then engaging what's called offline support. So the Google Drive is really important because that's basically where all of our files, all of our work gets stored. The nice thing about the Google Drive too is that it does not count Google Docs or Google Sheets, Google Slides. It doesn't count any of those files against your storage. So if you have a billion Google Docs, it still says that you're not using any space. So you say, well, how can I use up space inside my Google Drive? Well, if you upload photos to your Google Drive, it'll count that against you. Also, if you upload Microsoft Word documents or other types of files or programs, it'll count that space against you. And there's many different skills that we do cover in lesson number two. If you need to see it, there's the link above me, and go ahead and click that if you need the to go over just beyond the basics. Now let's go over to lesson number three. Hey, now we're going into another territory. Lessons 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 all cover Google Docs. But at the same time, I put in little mini lessons in there so that we also have lessons on Google Photos and other fun apps that we can use. Those are all part of the mini lessons that fit in between the main lessons. So as we can see here, here's Google Docs. And on lesson three, I would actually go over and go over the basics of basically using Google Docs, all the tools, all that can do. And then with the lessons from 4 all the way to lesson 8, I go in with practice. So the students are actually creating documents and learning those skills by actually doing. Now let's jump into lesson number 9. Hey, here we are in lesson number 9. Now, as we were saying, lessons 3 through 8 are all about Google Docs, but there's also lessons in there about Google Photos and other fun apps, even installing apps. Well, lesson 9 goes upon those skills and shows you how to install Microsoft Office, that is being Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, right onto your Google account, so that you'll be able to use it right on your Chromebook. And here in this lesson, we're going over the different tools that are found in Microsoft Office. We go in, and one of the things that we really require to use the Microsoft Office online is to have a Microsoft account. The good thing is Microsoft accounts are free. So I go in, I show you how to set up the account. Again, it's free. And then show you how to go into the App Store and actually find the Microsoft OneDrive as well as the Microsoft Office apps there. Once it's in your Google account, you'll actually be able to have access to it on your Chromebook and have be able to work with it that way. In this lesson, going over the tools, I go over Microsoft Word tools, Microsoft Excel tools, as well as the PowerPoint tools, which kind of set us up for going into lesson number 10, which goes into using Google Sheets. And it also has a little bit of a throwback to this lesson where we're also looking at Microsoft Excel. So let's jump into lesson 10 now. Now I group lessons 10, 11, and 12 together because in those lessons I teach how to use Microsoft Excel as well as Google Sheets. Now in lesson 10, I compare and contrast Google Sheets with Microsoft Excel, and I show you how to use both of those applications in lesson 10, going over all the tools and how they're similar and different between each other. In lessons 11 and 12, I go over working with actually creating projects using Google Sheets. And so they'll be making little charts, little spreadsheets, and workbooks in those lessons. Now, there's many lessons in between each of those videos as well, and those kind of go into more detail with Microsoft Excel and also with Google Sheets, and I cover a few other topics and skills as well in those lessons. So, go ahead and check out. You can check out lesson number 10 by clicking on the link above me there. Now on to lessons 13 and 14. In those lessons, I go over creating a presentation. And right at the very beginning of those lessons, I show you Microsoft's PowerPoint. I compare that to Google Slides, and I show them how they're similar and how they're different. Now, when we create presentations, really you can have a lot of imagination there. You can talk about a trip, you could talk about a story. So really those lessons, the students really get to be creative. So hopefully you like those. In lesson 14, I go over how to create a slide like a pro and actually create a really nice presentation. It takes a long time. It took me over a day to actually create that presentation, but in the video, it's kind of shrunken down to a little over an hour. And now on to lesson 15. Now in lesson 15, I go over how to use a smartphone and link it with your Google account so that you can have the exact same data on your home computer as well as on your smartphone. In fact, I show you how to do your work on your smartphone when you're away from home on a trip. So it's kind of neat because you can actually go into your Google Drive and then open up Google Docs and create or edit a document right there on your smartphone. The next thing I want to do is I want to thank all of the wonderful students out there who have been turning in their work faithfully every week. And it's just, it's a wonderful thing there to sit down, go to my Google Drive, go to the shared folder, and all this work would be there and turned in. I really appreciate that. And just, it's wonderful seeing how you've grown from lesson one through all the way to lesson 15 here, and going from the basics all the way to advanced and the skills with Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides. And I would recommend that you watch the other videos too that I have, because I do cover other skills and there's other things going on in the computer world that you can actually find out about just by going to my channel. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below, because I love to read your comments. And again, thank you very much, and bye-bye. Hey there, and welcome. My name is Mike, and in this whole video, come on, guys, you didn't even change his name.